I'm Tina McDonald, part of Spellbinders design team. Today I'm going to show you how I created this love banner. I created it using the Three's a Crowd, the Just Because, and the Leaves die sets. In creating today's project, I'm using the Platinum machine. Let's first cut out our pennants for the banner. So place a cutting plate onto the machine, followed by the Three's a Crowd steel rule die. We'll be using the triangle shapes for this banner. I love that there's two different sizes so we can easily layer our project. I'm going to place my pattern paper over the area of the die that I want to cut. It's okay if they overlap as it will still easily cut. Matter of fact, I could do two layers of paper for each if I like. Then we're going to cover it with a second cutting plate and run it through the platinum machine. Now adhere these papers together using foam tape with the smaller pennant on the top. We're going to repeat this step until we have the correct number of pennants that we need for our desired project. So depending how many letters are in the word you want to use, we're going to repeat until we have enough. Today, we need four. I've chosen these fun, dimensional-looking chipboard alphabet letters to add the letters to the word love in the center of each pennant. To string my banner, I'm using some double-sided tape across the top back of each pennant. Then I'm going to adhere it along that top edge to this beautiful shimmery green ribbon. Between each pennant on our banner, I wanted to create a fun embellishment, so let's do some more die cutting. Prepare the platinum machine by placing the platform as well as a cutting plate onto the machine. We're going to use these three flowers from the Just Because set, and we're going to cover it with two layers of pink paper. We'll also die cut our leaves here as well. These leaves are unique because there are several embossed detail pieces which could be used in the center of each one. So we're going to nest them together and cover them with green cardstock. Then cover all of this with a second cutting plate and then run it through the machine. The neat thing about these leaves dies is even though they have an embossed detail portion, there's actually no need to do the embossing step, because the machine has enough pressure that we get a great embossed detail just from the die cutting step. For our flowers, we're going to layer all three of the different sized pieces with the smallest one on top using foam squares for added dimension. I've also curled the petals a little bit and added a decorative gem to the center. For each flower that we create, we're going to want two matching leaves. So we're going to repeat the die cutting step with our leaves until we have two matching leaves for each flower. Now, add your flowers to your banner between each pennant and your project is complete. Thank you so much for joining me for today's tutorial. If you have any questions, please leave them in the space provided below and I'll be sure to get back to you. And thanks again for watching. Bye-bye.